So let's discuss about androgen anabolic steroid. So what is the effect of androgen anabolic steroid on the body? So this causes hypogonadism and patient may present with decreased libido, unable to sustain erection, benign erection, and may complain of fatigue, weight gain. Okay, so these are the symptoms when patient abuse androgen anabolic steroid, because this steroid causes decreased production of endogenous testosterone because of the suppression of gonadotropins through pituitary feedback. Okay, so when you take androgen anabolic steroids, then it suppresses pituitary and there is thus decreased production of testosterone. So patient may present with symptoms of hypogonadism. Okay, and testosterone level usually recover in weeks to months after discontinuation of this steroid, but chronic abuse can lead to prolonged and even permanent suppression of testosterone production. Okay, so if you discontinue the use of these products, then endogenous testosterone level recover in weeks to months, but if there is chronic abuse, then it can lead to prolonged or permanent suppression of endogenous testosterone production. Okay, and androgen anabolic steroid can cause erythrocytosis associated with increased erythropoietin production and suppression of hepcidin. And you can also see the lab picture like central hypothyroidism. Why? Because this steroid causes decreased synthesis of thyroxine binding globulin, and when there is decreased globulin, these proteins in the blood, then free T4 is elevated, so it suppresses pituitary because of the negative feedback, and there is thus decreased production of the thyroxine hormones from the thyroid gland. So overall looks like central hypothyroidism. Okay, and another thing is that when you see the patient presenting with this abuse, you can also suspect that he may have hemochromatosis. Your differential may come like this because patient presentation may look similar: decreased libido, fatigue, weight gain, and unable to attain erection. Okay, so if the patient complains these features and you see lab value showing increased hematocrit, hemoglobin increased, so you may suspect that he may also have hemochromatosis. But one thing I like to tell you, that hemochromatosis typically presents after age 40 because it takes some time to build up iron in the body. Okay, and when iron builds in enough amount, then only patient present with symptoms. Okay, so there may be elevated transaminase level in both cases, even in steroid abuse and in hemochromatosis cases. And hypogonadism, central hypogonadism may be present in both. So we have to think like that. And obviously we can do transparent saturations like those tests to differentiate, but clinically you can think like this. And also there is hyperpigmentation and arthralgia. Patient complains of these things prior to diagnosis of hemochromatosis. So clinically you can also differentiate between this hemochromatosis and androgenic anabolic steroid abuse. Okay.